In this video, I would like to explain how we would be calculating the interest rate that would allow money that we start with today to grow by every year for a specific number of years in order to reach a certain amount of money in the future. So let's say we have the following information. We have this timeline, today or year zero, right? This is today. We put, let's say $1,000, something simple. And let's say we have year one, year two, year three, year four, year five in the future, right? So this is all future years. And let's say in 5 years, we want money to double, right? So what does doubling your money means? It means today's $1,000 will become $2,000 after 5 years, right? And the question is, what should the annual interest rate be? So annual interest rate, which is R, should be some percentage, right, per year. How would we calculate this? Let's bring up the financial calculator. Let's turn it on. It's always a good idea to clear the calculator. In other words, to erase everything it might be still storing from any earlier calculations. So for that, press second, plus minus key, and enter. So now everything has been reset. So you put $1,000 that you have today. Let's say you deposited in some account, some investment, or maybe as simple as a bank account, right? And then after earning interest, it becomes twice that in 5 years. So $1,000 is the present value, right? Because we have the present value and the future value, $2,000, after 5 years, whenever we are dealing with $2 amounts, so one becoming something else in the future, one of them must be set as negative. So let's do that for $1,000. To make it negative, press the plus minus key on the bottom, and then save it as PV, which is present value. Then you enter the rest of the information. So $2,000 is our future value. And notice how I did not change the sign for it. I left it as is, as a positive value. Then they are 5 years apart, right? So I press 5, that's my number of years, that's between PV and FV, and I save it as N. And what I want to do is compute the interest rate, 14.87% per year. So this is what I'm going to put here, 14.87%. This is my answer. Now let's try something extra. Let's say we want to see how, at which rate it should be growing, $1,000 should be growing for the next 5 years so that the amount triples, right? Tripling means it's becoming $3,000 from the original $1,000. So again, what should be the annual interest rate? Annual interest rate, which we denote by R. So that's R is a typical notation when we use formulas by hand, which I'm skipping here. And in the financial calculator, R is the same thing as N. So what should it be? Some percentage. Okay, let's bring up the financial calculator again. We can clear everything, or we technically don't need to right now because everything will be overwritten with the new values. So again, by the way, in no particular order, you enter $1,000 present value, 5 the number of years, and the future value. So let's start with the future value, 3,000. And you get to pick which one is positive, which one is negative, between $1,000 and $3,000. So now let's make $3,000 negative. Plus minus key, FV, which means future value. $1,000 is left as is and saved as present value, PV key. They are 5 years apart. I press 5N, and I want to compute the required interest rate that would be earned every year in order for the money to change to triple. Compute IY, 24.57% every year. So 24.57. This is the required interest rate for the money to triple. And by the way, the formula that I've been using is, you know, if you want to do this kind of math by hand, which formula would you use? So future value equals present value multiplied by 1 plus the interest rate to the power of t. And now we are actually solving for the interest rate. And in this case, this can be calculated as future value divided by present value to the power 1 divided by t, and then you subtract 1. So this is kind of the math that you can also use to solve this kind of problems.